Yeah, welcome to this video tutorial. In this video, let us understand how to make database connection and how to get the connection string and what is data directory, how to use the data directory to replace the path. So when you have a connection string, we'll have the complete path where is your database located. So in order to avoid the path, we can use the data directory. So data directory is a environment variable, so we'll give the path automatically. So we can use the data directory in the connection string. So this is the part 2 of the VB.NET project, like how to make the VB.NET project. Keep watch and learn how to make the VB.NET project yourself. Okay, let's start Visual Studio 2019. Here it is 2019. And now you need to select the project. So let's create a new project again. So this time we'll give a different name for the project. So here you need to select desktop application. So this is a desktop, and in desktop you have to say .NET framework and Visual Basic. So there are so many types are there. So just search for, okay, so straight away search for Visual Basic, that is better. Visual Basic. So now we'll have Windows Forms application .NET framework. So you need to select the .NET framework. This is the language Visual Basic. And here's for Windows and is the desktop application. So take care, you need to select the proper project. Okay, so this is a Windows form or .NET framework, not .NET, it is a .NET framework, and you have to select this type and then say next. Then you have to give the project name. So I'll just give as a college management only. So college management. So where you would like to save this project, so you have to browse here. Now you would like to save it in D drive. And then VB project. So here we want to save the project. Select folder. And here you can see that place solution and the project in the same directory. Fine. So therefore all the files will be in the same directory. And here's the .NET framework. Which version you would like to use. So we can use any of these versions. So 4.6 is okay. Let's select 4.6. If you have different version in your system, no problem. You select that one. Okay. Next you click the create button. So you can see that now it is a college management. So form is one form by default, there is a form one. So we can change the background color of this form. So back color. Okay, I'll change some color. Okay. So this color is changed. Now again, let us create the database. So go to Server Explorer. Okay. I delete the one which is already there. So data connections, then add connections, the browse. So now you can see that project name is different, college management, bin folder, debug folder. So here you have to give the database name. So let's give us a college management database. So open. Okay. Do you want to create it? Yes. First time you need to create it. So next time you don't need to. You can select, because database will be there in the particular location, we can select it and it will link to the connections. Now, once you select this one, so you expand this, there is a tables here. There are no tables, right click here, and then you can say new query. And we already written the query in the last video. I'll just copy the same and then I'll paste it here. So you can execute this. So here is the execute button. Now you can see table is created. So we go to Server Explorer and refresh this. There is a table. Now that is done. Now we need to obtain that connection string. So to obtain the connection string, you can come back to Server Explorer, then select the data connections and then select college management database. In the properties window, so here is the properties window. In case you don't have the properties window here, what you have to do, you go to view menu, then select properties window here. So properties window, it is here. Okay. So sometime it is there in the other windows. So check it out here. If not there, so you can check where it is. Otherwise you can also use Control W. So here is the properties window. Now, so you can remove the auto add. So this is the pin. So make it visible here. So let it be visible and select the database. Then you go to connection string here and you have to select the complete connection string. So double click on this or you press home button, then shift end button, then copy. So now it's copied. So how the connection string looks now. So I'll just take to the notepad. So earlier we copied here and then pasted. Okay. So this is how the connection string looks. Now what we can do is, so instead of taking the complete path here, so we can remove this path. In place, we can use the directory, data directory. So how to do this? So here you can see that there is a slash here. So this is the path. You can take out the path and then you have to use the piping. So to piping. Inside that you have to write data directory. Now this data directory will give the complete path. Whatever this path is there, will give the complete path. Fine. Now our connection string is ready. Then how to use the connection string in the VB.NET. Now let's take a button. So I go to toolbox. So let me have a button here. I double click here. So it will take to the code window. And the first line, so you make a space here. Go to first line. You have to import system.data.sqlclient. So this is a namespace. We call it as a namespace here, or it's a library. So in order to work with database, you require this library or the namespace. That is system.data.sqlclient. So all the required things are written in the particular namespace. Therefore, you need to use that one. After that, so we need to declare a variable, a dim SQL CYNN, okay, let's say SQL connection as new SQL connection. So it should be SQL connection because first time we need to connect. So therefore you can write SQL connection. So open bracket, then the close bracket. So this is dim SQL as a new SQL connection. So this is the first step. First step is you need to import system.data.sqlclient. That is important. After that you need to declare the SQL connection. So now once you have SQL connection, so we need to tell the system where is your database. So therefore the connection string is required. So therefore the connection string we already done. Okay. So there is data directory here that is changed. I copy this again. Then you can put a double quotes and inside the double quotes you need to paste this. Now you can see that. So here is the connection string. So that should be inside the double quotes. And also this SQL connections, now we can use it in the wherever you want. So in this particular form. Now how do we do work with SQL connections? First we need to check whether you can open the connection or not. For that you have to write SQL connection dot open. When you say open, so it will establish a link to the database, and if there are no errors means it's working fine. Okay, let me run this. Now you can see that we have a form here. When I click the button, so there is no error, means it's everything is fine, it's working. Let's see that I'll make a small change here. Okay, so database 1.mdf. I add 1 over there. Now let me run this. So I'll click the button. So you can see that there is an error here. Exception unhandled. So what it says that there is a violation. Specified file cannot be opened or it is located on UNC share. It means it cannot able to access this database. But anyhow, college management database 1.mdf is not available in that particular folder. So therefore you can't able to move to that folder. Even sometime is local DB. Okay. So here is a local DB. So you assume that there is a small mistake over there. So DB, I just make only D. So immediately there is an invalid key. So it will not acceptable. Fine. So it's supposed to be DB. Any small mistake will lead to problems. Okay. So therefore you need to see that the connection string is in order. And then once you open the connections, we can close the connection. sql.connection.close. So we need to close the connection. So open the connection and then close the connection. So let's run it again. So click the button. So fine. Everything is working fine. There's no problem. That's how we can obtain the connection string from the database. From SQL server, we can connect the collect the connection string and then make the connection string ready. In the next video, we'll see that how to link to the table and how we can enter the data to the table. That we can learn in the next video.